just to give him something like this.
Yeah, it's a tough call, really. And we already see top a TP out by Puppy, actually.
He's the man with the ward play.
He's going to go here and put down a ward. So Tiki is straight up running towards bottom.
So it looks like, okay, well, before we get ourselves carried away, we start talking about lanes. We can welcome in everyone in from the mainstream. We got the wish. Santa has arrived, and it is Christmas in July. It is Secret Techies game with Tuskar up against Cloud9 MTI5, game number 2 of this 2-game series.
Hey, man. S4 said it at ESL. Techie is one of those first pick, first bad material heroes. He's just not really being given that first pick, but...
He's legit, is what he is. He's legit.
Definitely dangerous when you have him in a combination. On his own, kind of hard to play out, but it can definitely work. And they see the gyrocopter as he moves down here, standing on top of the ward, trying to bait someone, I actually believe, because he has his team around. Mm-hmm. Probably knows that there is a sentry around.
Puppy's bringing 2 sentries down on the courier. There's only 1 ward which is blocking the first pull point. So they haven't really, like, obviously because of Secret's positioning, Cloud9 couldn't contest the entire jungle with wards.
Because that's what you want to do against the Chen. You want to run out and force down a lot.
They're going to try and fight this. Kuro, the man, the front lines. They might think a level 1 fight would be good for Cloud9.
And oh, the snowball.
Oh, that Light Strike array is a long, long way away. They have snowball and No-Tail. He's gone inside the pit here. Isolated. The shards will keep Roshan away from No-Tail. Zai will move in, and Kuro gets the first blood. Okay, he actually uses just the mine to do the work.
Yeah, and the last hit goes to Techie, so good starting gold for him there. Definitely gonna need it. And very hard for C9 to contest that rune at all. Seems that they're gonna mind game a little bit with how they lane this. RTZ running all the way towards the top lane, where he's gonna be soloing it up against Darkseer.
So that's not really a bad lane. It's gonna be... wait for the creep wave to come under the tower and then farm it up style of lane. But it leaves Zai and Kuro to go up against Envy and Misery. And it will in fact be No-Tail as well. So it is a try off lane for Cloud9. And they Stormbolt. They're chasing out the Kuro. They know he doesn't have suicide. So one quick mine is all he can do. Does damage across all 3. But Cloud9 shutting down the techies.
Yeah, very strong try lane here. With the Shadow Wave early on, you can't really fight into that. And as you said, you don't have suicide.
I love this from Fada as well as Chen. Now with the strike on Fada, he can go for the clap and slow him down. The Lightstrike array will still connect.
Will kill
the
him.
Puppy just goes to work, and then the blink over. He avoids the slave.
The salve.
They'll come into the slave right now. The salve right now. S4 munching on the trees, but the salve is not going to do enough. Heal all the tango. The charge was enough. Misery. He's going to arrive. S4 is dead. He does 1 last shadow strike, but he'll go down for the count.
Wow, Misery already part of 2 kills here, and of course No-Tail as well, as they make good rotations. So supports from C9, already knowing what to do.
Yeah, they've done it beautifully. And you always know the Puppy is going to be that big problematic kind of player. He wanted the Enchantress because that way he could at least have like the Hellbear there and get something else to inflict a different lane. Now Snowball bottom lane, Envy, it's just the explosion from the techies.
Oh,
but now
Zai's
also going to go down. He got ensnared. He couldn't get the last punch into the Tusker.
Yeah, it's the Warcry doing so big of a difference here, because you get 5 bonus armor. And that's just enough, you know. They cannot kill them with suicide.
This is going to be a rough game for Scriff. I feel so sorry for our cameraman.
Things going on all over the map.
It can happen in a moment, and that's all that was. Like, it was a small inch snowball in Tanaga, thinking that's going to be a way they can shut down Envy.
Suicide to Roshan by No-Tail, just traveling back to base, so buying all his items first, of course. Eternal Envy at TI5, Gyrocopter 0-3, Antimage 0-3, Razor 0-1. What?
Wait, that's not a really great result.
That doesn't sound great.
that's a shame game right there. That's...
Yeah. I mean, you basically brought up all the heroes he has lost on. Come on now. That's... Yeah.
Yeah, Gyrocopter 3-0. I'm like, wait, hang on. I was fairly certain we just had a victory for Cloud9 and Gyrocopter.
Yeah.
That's better. All right, so there's no suicide attack for Kuro. You don't have momentum, and this lineup is so critical to get that momentum. It's almost like a slow down time. Stack up in the jungle, farm with the Wild Wing. Puppy's capable of doing that, even though it's currently on cooldown.
Yep.
S4's lane in the mid, 11-4 up against the 13-3, fairly well balanced. And Arteezy's found a decent amount of farm as well. And what's in return? Like, the big call for C9 is the Naga Siren, who is now getting something, but the Darkseer was the one who was taking it all beforehand.
Definitely. It's so interesting seeing these lane switches. Talked to some of the players earlier on the day before the wild cards, actually. And everyone was saying that the lane switches are super important. And if you cannot do them or if you don't understand them, you're going to lose straight up. And that's what we see every game, like switches.
Smoke. They're coming in for fodder.
Yep, they want to go behind.
The snowball in towards the lean. It's a long way to travel. That's why they had to put the shards up first with the scream. That's the death of fodder. And again, Kuro with the landmine finding the last hit.
Yeah, very nice there for Secret, because there was also a gank coming from C9, but that was just slightly too late. A little bit harder for them to gank the Queen than it is to gank the Lina.
We actually have the rotations now, so hello, Kuro. He's moving up towards the north, trying to make it a little bit more difficult to farm up inside the jungle of C9.
Look at
obviously, when Darkseer goes missing, that's exactly what you're expecting to happen.
Yeah.
And Suicide attacks off cooldown in 13 seconds time too, so they can just get the pop kill.
They have been they have been scouted here, though, by the wards, so they're running around in the enemy jungle, but the enemy know that. So C9, fully aware of this.
That's the reason why Misery has been brought to the mid lane, and Notel, well, he'll walk back as well, S4. He doesn't have vision of Notel, but the Lightstrike Array, Fader, this is now, what, two or three that he's missed? The initial one in the bottom lane fight?
Yeah. It's difficult. S4 has been very good with his positioning as well, so hard to get that. Meanwhile, Kuroki trying to set up a little death trap to the right there. And they're trying to go in. They have the suicide.
Here they come. And Fada's going to be the main target. Jump in with a scream. And just a suicide from Techies, but the shallow grave. The perfect timing there from Notel. There is still, however, shards available, but Fada, with stick charges and bottle charges, he gets his life back very quickly.
Dazzle and Sven, very good counter heroes to the Techie lineup, actually. The grave, of course, doing the most work, but also the Warcry. Dying so much of the damage in some of the fights.
Is it still worth the time, though, C9? Because you've got Notel, who spent a lot of time just walking around the Radiant Ancients, and Misery waiting behind him as well. Yes, you stopped the kill from happening on your Lina. I'm never going to say that's a bad thing. Mm-hmm. But the Gyrocopter's getting farmed. And I think we've seen Gyro carry a lot of games this tournament.
I think it's necessary. I don't think you have a choice, because there are ganks being thrown towards the Lina. Well, they're going mid.
S4,
going
on the got a blink.
Yeah. I mean, there are ganks happening towards the Lina, and that's Lina's one weakness. She's a super strong 1v1 hero, but when you bring in people, she has no survivability. No armor, nothing. It's not like the Queen. So they're more here to protect her.
Okay, well, that's only going to last for so long. I'm still looking at Puppy, who they haven't stopped in the jungle. He's got 25 CS so far, trying to come down for the haste rune. You were thinking about denying it. Sorry, the bouncy rune. Thinking about denying it. Kuro, top lane, having a crack over on Envy. No suicide attacks. They need this mine to go to work again. And the control time, just not enough. The shallow grave kicks in from Notel. Maybe a little bit premature as Kuro trying to back it up. Zai ensnared for the moment. And Fader with that Laguna Blade able to find the kill. And Kuro, he knew he was dead.
Yeah, double damage as well. And Lina just easily clicking. It wouldn't even have mattered. Kills the Techie with ease. And they're struggling a lot on this Techie and Tusk combination. We were excited when we were going to see it, but I'm more excited now by how well C9 are countering it.
Yeah, they've definitely, like, you'd expect coming into a tournament that there would be some level of prep done to counter the Techie's pick, because everyone was expecting it.
Yeah, we saw it at ESL, and we have seen in some online tournaments as well how strong it can be. So definitely no surprise, but it's a smart and simple counter.
Artizi's still taking, like, a lot of farm off this bottom lane. He's looking for the kill on Bone 7. The chain creep's doing some good harassment. Now they snowball in, and for the call down, Bone 7 gets hit by the first rocket. The Santa Blast from Puppy will find the kill, and they discover Misery, but there's no stun available, and not enough damage to kill him before the TP will complete.
Yep, easy, safe TP out for him, but they did bring down the Dazzle, so they got that going, and 169 gold is all they're gonna get from him, because this is not a very, very rich kill.
A small amount.
Yeah.
Little by little, big things get done.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, Envy. He's at the fourth highest net worth now after having to play that offlane. But yeah. He had a lot of space on top of
it. It's the, like, offlane until level 2.5 or 3, and then you switch. Like, that's the current style at TI, that a lot of teams just start out with some lane and then switch when you have gotten the initial start on the hero that you wanted to have a good start. Mm-hmm. So it's very curious.
Wondering how long though Secret was going to let this go. Because you're still looking at, okay, a really nicely farmed up Gyro, but this gank train from Zai as well as Kuro hasn't been anywhere near as effective as they would have really liked it to be. Shallow Grave and Warcry being a major problem in that.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't know. It's fun to see Misery just farming here right underneath Artizi as he's farming up the stacks.
They
Misery
should be leeching each other's experience.
They are. And he's going to go and take a lot of experience here and going to steal some creeps.
Sent back. The Storm Bolt will be thrown out by Misery, but...
Yeah, that one doesn't matter much. I suppose brought back to base, but he stole a lot there and just messing with Arteezy's farm. As you said, he has been free farming a lot, but now Misery trying to be on top of that.
Fade is also having a little bit of trouble keeping S4 out of his jungle. Picked up an illusion rune, so we scout out the fact there's a stack. So Fade is going to farm it up as quick as he can now.
Yeah, and S4 has really good game going for him. 45 last hits and 9-9 against the 44.
On top lane, they're going after Notel. With a call down from Gyro, they bring down the Dazzle, so no more Shallow Grave for him.
Yeah.
And Kuro is, with S4, Dyer's now going to inflict damage into this tower. So the mine's Radiant level 2 only, but still attack. Has a lot of damage being inflicted into buildings.
Yeah, they're still very strong, adding a lot to the push. And Tuskar keeps finding initiations all over the place. Of course, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Here they go again. Fada, low on life. S4 is going to commit the Sonic Wave and Blink 4 to ensure the kill. There is the Hand of God available from Puppy if things get a little bit rough.
Oh, and Kuro, he wants the Queen, but she's too fast. Go on Kuroki. He has to suicide, but they can't even force it, I think.
After the stun, they can't keep chasing.
Yeah, it's the same the other way around. The Sven and the Dazzle bring a lot of physical damage, but Teki has plenty of armor, actually. So... very easy for him to survive that.
I'm wondering too, when Kuro is able to get his next item, he's been walking around with these semi-items for a while, so they're giving him the space in the mid to try and find some of this.
Interesting stat there, that the only time that Teki and Tusk lost together was against Complexity. And that was when Summer's Rift played it. Wow. Just interesting. It's only been played 6 times though. We get very hyped when we see it.
Alright, so you were talking about the push power coming out from Team Secret.
Look at Chen.
Lightstriker Ray gonna miss again, so S4's fine. Yeah, Chen's got a lot of levels over on him at the moment and almost finished the mech. When is the timing and what really, like, is it just a tier 1 tower push? Do they look for more?
It is now. I mean, he has the army coming with him now. His entire hood is joining with this, so... this when they want to push, they send back the gyrocopter so he can TP back up again if he wants to and help the push even more. I think he will.
She pick up the Morbid Mask on Gyro early too.
Yeah.
So, not just rushing in a drum, so she having some lifesteal behind him.
They showed all the creeps on Chen though. They're not going to start with this push with a gank, so they're just going to reveal it. We'll see if they can hold it.
The whole move has been revealed. There's a Dire Observer Ward watching the lane TPs.
Yeah.
So they, like, C9 see everything. It's up to them if they want to try and defend this. The Weave also now coming into play, so the armor is starting to rise. At the same time, Kuro is just having an absolute ball of a time. Pushing up the mid, now throwing down some bigger powder kegs, but it's the wrap around from behind. Misery looking for Arteezy. There's still 5-1 charges in their hand of God, but the fact they hold in the wall with the Laguna Blade as well. The heavy committal onto Arteezy to ensure
they get kill the creeps, I think.
And they, well, with, yeah, they got the surge, but Misery, the nuke of the shards coming up. They're backing up. There's double Satter Blast. Okay, there's only one now available, but they get Misery away.
Yeah, Tusk wants to go in and try and punish here, but everyone is still alive. Naga could TP in.
Shah's just hurt Fade.
Oh, Naga has no mana. Yeah, they're going to get this easier.
So they kill Arteezy, but they lose the tier 1 tower, but Eternal Envy never arrived.
Yeah, so
we're back into like almost the same situation as game 1. Space creation for Envy to get the Radiance.
Exactly. I would say that's pretty much a wash, though. Like, losing Arteezy and getting a tier 1, meanwhile Envy was farming. If anything, it's a slight win for C9, because you expect more to happen there when you have the Chen. You have such a committed lineup to that push, and you still lost the fight. So, I think C9 are very happy with the way things are going. Looking at 2,000 gold on the Naga, so when she gets the Radiance, that's when this starts to get tough.
Yeah. And I'm wondering how you even stop that then. Like, what's the plan for Secret to... like, is it just a couple of landmines, different positions to get rid of the illusions before they can do any kind of push or damage?
Not really. I think remote mines, if anything, if you want to kill that. But then you need to start getting farm on your techie. You need level 11, you need maybe an Aghanim's. Like, then you can start, you know, dealing with that.
S4's pinging out. He wants a little bit of help. Now, the Dire Observer Ward and Sentry is there, so they do see that remote mine just sitting in the mid lane. They'd love to get rid of it. While S4 just wants to blink and Sonic Wave almost everyone. The Centaur from Puppy doing the scouting. S4 can almost hit 2 heroes here with just, in fact, 3 heroes here with the Sonic Wave.
He's faking it.
Oh, they saw him. The Weave actually gave vision on the high ground. It didn't affect S4, but it gave him the vision.
Yeah, definitely. It scouted him. But he was actually canceling his ulti there. But all of C9, apart from Envy, just defending mid. That's exactly how they want to play this. Keep farming with Envy. Leave all the other lanes to him. their playstyle.
But Arteezy's doing the same thing, like Envy and Arteezy on polar sides of the map.
But they're not the same hero, though, and Naga becomes a lot more scarier when she finishes up the Radiance than when the Arteezy finishes up Helm of Dominator and Sanxia or something
That's
like
true.
That.
That's true, unless Secretly able to push fast enough to get the trade-off. And with the mech over on the Chen and Hand of God coming up, actually, where is that? Mech hasn't finished yet.
Yeah.
He bought Arcane Boots instead.
He did. Arcane Boots can be really important for them as well, since they're running a techie, so it's no surprise. Also, the Tusk has had some mana issues, but he has Arcane Boots of himself.
Alright, smoke movement from Secret. This should be a Roshan move.
Yeah, I think
so. They were scouting it out before to make sure everything's clear.
They have the medallion, they have everything, they're prepared for this Rosh.
Yep.
So just gonna go with the Chen Creeps. They even have the Ice Armor, so 13 armor on this troll.
And Kuro could prepare the defense. Like, he's getting remote mines as well as wards here. So if C9 want to try and stop this, like, don't
tell. Is he gonna weave it?
He should. He really should weave it. Radiant's top tower is under Kuro doesn't have a lot more to work with, though. Like, he could throw down another remote mine in a second.
Yeah,
and they threw down
a sentry
ward. There's the weave. So Roshan.
He's pinging it like ping,
2.7k.
Oh, they have the song. They're coming in with Naga.
Yeah, Paternal Envy. He's gonna turn on the music. And here it comes. They actually slow it all down. Roshan walking out the pit.
There's a
remember,
lot of mines.
There's two remote mines. Bone7 almost killing himself on that. Then with the other explosion, only hit Misery and Puppy nuking. And a perfect wall into the Sonic Wave from S4. They're taking out two. Roshan killed by Arteezy at the same time.
Oh, disaster. Woo. Could not strike harder. But at least they get out safely with their Envy and Lina. And Sven, of course, manages to get away as well. But that was
Fader,
not
Fader.
Great.
Maybe he's got a chance here. Arteezy, there's your Hand of God. And they're coming in for the Snowball.
Oh,
actually
up.
Picking up Arteezy so he can go into the Rocket Barrage. It is worse. And maybe with the heal, he'll get the stun. Misery, though, the Rocket Barrage is just so much damage with the shards as well. They give a double kill to Arteezy. No Tail will arrive, but to achieve only a weave.
Yeah, and they still have Aegis. All that for an attempt to kill the Aegis. They lose two more heroes, two important ones as well, or at least Lina, the most important one right now to keep up fighting while Naga's farming. Suddenly this game started looking a lot worse for C9. They are at the gold to finish up the relic, but this gold momentum from Roshan, from towers, suddenly the pressure.
They lost about 6,000. Like, that was a swing to Secret as far as experience go.
Yep.
Gold was only a swing of 3,000, but I say only 3,000 when you're 16 minutes into a game. That's still a hell of a lot.
It is.
And Kuro got a lot of levels from that too. He's got 4 levels up in the mines. Hilariously enough, he's planning it right next to the Tire Observer.
Yeah, they saw what he was up to there.
Yeah.
Sometimes they will have vision on you. That's unfortunate for Kuro. He's going to go back and plant one more landmine, I think, and then back out. But, shouldn't achieve too much. They're gonna actually chase him. They're mad at this little bastard.
Well, Fada knows it's a free kill.
Fada can kill him.
Like,
sure.
All he's gotta do is just get the Yules into Light Strike Array and Laguna.
Yeah.
It's a low cooldown.
No
so
mana for Suicide as well, so this Techie is dead.
Yeah. He left the keg instead to keep the vision up.
Rejoice, Techie haters. You get to see him die.
The issue though is the fact that they still have vision all through the Dire Jungle. Like, the Observer was watching the mid area.
Look at that move,
and
though.
Now Misery just, okay, he decided to walk through.
Yeah, he has 4 points into the Warcry. This is specifically against the Techie. So he gets 20 armor. I think I missaid and said 16 earlier. That's the old, it is buffed since then. But the 20 armor, just able to run through it.
So he's a mind clearer. That's,
yeah.
That's what Sven is. He's a bulldozer.
He is Minesweeper. Very effective.
Well, this tier 1 tower stays unnumbered. As Secret bring in their Chen army. They are losing their armor, of course, but they've also got a little bit of a counter to that. So Puppy managed to pick up an Ogre Frost Mage. So they're getting a little bit of their armor back. It's a little bit. We have still a problem, though.
Yeah, Frost Armor is really good. It's a very nice spell. This Frost Armor, though, does not slow down range attacks like the Lich. Lich is he's the master of Frost Armor.
Yeah. Full Orchid. 18 minutes now up for Queen of Pain flying in on the Courier.
Very nice. Orchid is going to help them a lot. It's great against Arcs here. One of the best items you can get against them.
Arteezy stunned up. Fada. Yule Scepter. Light Strike Array now going to go for it, but then he gets Orchid and then just instantly snowballed. The Shallow Grave will keep him alive, but the cooldown, it will connect on Notel. But Arteezy, the flat cannon damage, he's trying to reach up far enough. Notel will drop down very, very low, but Secret still get their objective. They still get tier 2.
Yep. And they do it in a convincing fashion as they push there. They don't even have Techie there. He doesn't need to be there. So he's been, you know, just running around trying to plant some more mines, get some vision up.
He wants levels. He wants to get the like, you saw the ineffectiveness of the Kegs.
Yeah.
Around Roshan. Oh, like, yeah. We're all expecting, like, a huge explosion, remembering what Kuro has done with this guy before. And then you're like, wait, no, that's a level 1 pound cake.
Yeah, exactly. And there was only 2 level 1 remote mines. They don't do that much. However, when they start claiming more and more map control, like they are now, removing another tier 2 tower, they're actually going to be able to shut in C9 a lot. And they need to buy a gem for Envy soon. And just put that. Speaking of Envy, look at his gold. He has the Radiance in just 75 more gold.
Well, fun times, but there's only one tier 2 tower remaining on their side of the map.
Yeah. Harsh.
And at the same time, I'm also seeing a triple agent stack for the Gyrocopter, who has a full SMY.
He just barely needs a little bit more gold in the jungle, and then the Techie comes in and steals it.
Okay, yeah. You're not going to achieve that.
Yeah, that was...
This ward's also going to time out in 10 seconds.
It is. But yeah, the full SMY, as you say, is what Arteezy likes to build. I think I've seen it in every game that he played Gyrocopter that we cast. He's been building the Helm of Dominator SMY build.
Okay, so they destroyed the Keg inside the Dire Jungle, revealing the fact that Sentry Ward's there. If Secret come Dire's up, which they probably will, as Kuro's got a Sentry up his sleeve, he's gonna find the Dire Observer Ward, which was freshly placed.
Yeah, if he manages to find that though. Not certain yet. He's rushing for the Force Staff as well. Very common if you're playing this kind of not farming Techie, just running around and supporting. If you can get the Force Staff, you're going to be more than happy.
He's playing the lane control Techies.
Yeah.
Like he's exploding remote mines to stop these Naga illusions from pushing anything.
Yeah, they're still going to get the farm though. Envy is on top of that game. He has been playing some Naga farming games before in his ranked games. I've seen it.
At the same time, like, have they got the money? Okay, yeah, there's definitely money for a gem, but Lina wants her Aghanim Scepter first.
Yeah, that's what she should be building into. She has too low HP right now, so getting the full Aghanims would be amazing. Queen going
soon.
For a solo kill on Envy.
Can he do it with the Orc and Sonic Wave? That should pop him.
Oh, no, the
Is
bottle.
It enough? He's low.
The bottle
And now
enough.
The Song of the Siren. Ensure the runaway for Puppy. Oh, Father's going to send him up, and there is the Chen army behind him. The Song of the Siren protecting Puppy for a moment.
Yep, managing to get away at least.
But that's
not
song
gonna
down.
Die.
That's yep. song down. You could potentially think about doing damage on high ground, but you also blew your Sonic Wave.
I mean, at least it's a very easy tier 2 top. If you just go and push there, you're going to get that very easily, as there's no way for Naga to really contribute now. Arteezy just clearing the creeps, and like to see Misery pushing so far out there, trying to cover this push.
He can only do a little bit. Kuro is already preparing the perimeter of remote mines across the map. And a very early Greaves, 21 minutes in, Chen was able to finish the full Greaves.
Mm. Yeah, Darkseer is going for it as well, but yeah, Chen has his Greaves already. Very nice item for him. Greaves actually so much better for Chen than the old mana boots and mech. If you want to go into Aghanim's Chen now, you don't have the same mana issue that you used to. So, it works really well.
The beauty of the new items.
Yeah.
Cloud Knight grouping up as 4 on the top. Meanwhile, in the Radiant Jungle, Puppy is chasing a very pesky Naga Siren. Now, there is no Song of the Siren. Zai can't get close enough that he can catch up to Envy, but now he will. Can he get the punch in time? Yes, he can.
He
the
it.
TP cancelled. This should be the death of Eternal Envy. In fact, it will be. The call down from Jara will do the work.
Eternal Envy goes down.
At the same time, it's buying more space for the rest of Cloud9 now.
Yeah, it's always about trying to create as much space as possible if you're gonna die. So he died far into the Radiant side of the map, trying to force them far away, at least.
S4... Not where he wants to
S4
be.
Doesn't have any defensive item, and he was scouted out by that ward, so maybe C9 could think about fighting that. But with all of Secret coming, they're just gonna back out.
Yeah. And they're happy with this, like, Secret's wasting their time. Like, Arteezy's farming up the Ancients, which is great for him.
Yeah.
He's actually at a point now where he can pick up the Demon Edge.
Exactly. So Arteezy's getting strong. That's fine for Secret. But same for C9. Like, they lost. Oh, wait. They're running into Arteezy here.
Maybe this is not the greatest position for it. Yeah, Arteezy after point 7. The mech and Shallow Grave TP out. He's got no points up at homing missile to do anything. In fact, both will TP out safely.
TP outs everywhere from C9.
And we got the Trip Centaur from Poppy.
Yeah, that's the creeps you want to have around this stage. So good. Also has the one armor creep, which is going to do a lot of work against the Weave, of course.
Not that bad as well as cleaning off the Naga illusions. When you got that test of faith.
Yeah, it's okay. He's not that great at it, but at least they have, they're pretty decent heroes for killing Naga illusions. They would have done a lot better job doing it with the Lion, but hey man, then they couldn't have the techies.
Is there a clock right now for Secret to win this game on? Or is Arteezy going to be big enough that he can keep carrying later into the game?
Against Naga, there's always a clock. Because it doesn't matter how farmed you are. Against a good player with gear cap on Naga, you can straight up lose. Like, no matter what items you have on your carry, you can just always lose the game.
So, with a fresh BKB over on Arteezy, is this the time you feel they should be looking at tier 3 towers at least?
I think so. This is the time to start at least cracking up to tier 3. And maybe even more.
But they might just start losing out. Like, this Naga is creep-skipping into the mid lane, yep, taking out the bottom lane with the help now of Misery, who triggered God Strength to try and take out this tower.
You think this is bad? Wait till he has Octarine and Manta. Dyer's you better go now.
You've got, okay, you've Aghanim Scepter on Lina, but you've got a Blink Dagger on Bone 7. C9 are actually in a position where they can try and fight. Arteezy, front of the lines,
beautiful,
and they
shard.
Caught out Fada. But Fada, there will be that Shallow Grave to keep him alive.
Die.
He will still end up dying, but at least he gets his damage out while the Flat Cannon taking care of the Naga illusion. So there's no more Radiance, but apart from Naga herself.
Oh,
and
the wall is
so far back.
Oh,
if they chase out here, there's still two remote mines down. And they're level 2 remote mines. They're running into him right now. Envy's got to be careful. He knows it. But yeah, they shards, they hold him in, and now Song of the Siren. But what's this for? Is it just a retreat?
Yeah, I mean, vacuum cooldown is basically like an ulti nowadays, right? So they don't have time to do it again.
There's 3 remote mines now by Koro.
Yeah, 4 now.
Yeah.
He's just stacking up, making safe spot for him to retreat into, even some stasis traps as well, to make sure that they can feel safe back there. Lina is responding.
7, the back, there's no wall. And now Arteezy on the front lines with the Rocket Barrage. He's going up to Notel with a cooldown Envy. He's going to bring him down. Cloud9 being sieged inside their own base. They can't push him. The greed's from Puppy, bringing Secret back to full life, still with the Centaur army.
Oh, there's no stopping Secret now.
They're TPing forward. Bone 7, he actually TPs in, but he's not ready. There's no walls. Now they go for the Orchid over on Fada. Sonic Wave, Misery, the Rocket Barrage will finish the job on that front. And Fada also falls back. Buyback now comes from Misery, but they already took the melee rack. Secret just want to back up over the mines.
Remotes.
You've got to be careful. Bone 7's close. The fact they still need to fall back a little bit further. Tuskar Snowball going in a little bit deeper. And Secret's just like, please pull back as far as you can right
they have
now.
No detection.
Fada's so close, and they're not doing it. Like, C9, they have to know. They have to know!
They have no detection though, they can't go in there.
They're not gonna come out. Look at him, he's throwing it in front of their faces.
Arteezy is like, yeah, come get me, try.
This is the safe zone.
Yeah. Is under attack. This is the spot that you cannot enter. Kuroki is just being cocky right now.
He's trying to force half Envy into it.
Yeah, and I think there are mines there, guys.
Now it's time to back up. So they bring out observers and sentries. It's too short.
Yeah,
the first sentry's too short.
They're just being safe. They're gonna drop the next one at a recent distance. Now they know they're not gonna die.
All right. So back to the lane pushing. Puppy's waiting for a new creep.
Yeah, Puppy. And at the same time, what are we looking at for gold right now over on the side? There's plenty of gold on the side of Secret all over.
I'm surprised Kuro continues to prep.
Oh, they're smoking around.
Yeah, they're coming behind them.
Here.
So there's one way to get around the remote mines, but there's a remote mine on top of the hill. So there is vision to be given from this, and they can just play around their own mines.
They see Puppy. They're going to kill Puppy.
Okay, that's one way.
Oh, actually, they're kind of indecisive.
The cooldown's going to come in with the Flag Cannon. Misery's going to lose a lot of life. The War Cry is giving a lot of life to work with.
That's not great for them. They just went... Oh my god.
Yeah.
They're calling GG.
GG.
On it.
That's it. It was the last YOLO loop.
Man, you could see in that last fight how they were not agreeing on what to do. Like, some of them wanted to kill Puppy, some of them wanted to go on the Techie and the Tuskar, and they just ended up going on both and losing both the fights. I think they were already screwed at that point though, but that was the last nail in the coffin.
But this is what we're expecting from someone like a Techies. Techies makes you play a very different style of game to what you normally